So, here to talk about divorce. If everything that I read is right, about half of you in this room know quite a bit about this topic. It's a word that's often laced with bitterness, sadness, anger, all kinds of negative things, but I actually think that it doesn't have to be that way. Let's face it, marriage is really hard. It often, or probably usually, doesn't work, but just because you didn't have a happy marriage, it doesn't mean that you can't have a friendly divorce. Just because someone's your ex, I don't know who said that you're obligated to dislike that person. I actually think that it's a lot easier to put your energy toward loving someone than it is toward hating them. And it turns out that's actually better for your health. So I like to subscribe to that rule. But it's not like I can really claim to be any sort of expert. I've actually only been divorced for not even a whole year. But I think I've learned a lot in a short amount of time. So I wanted to share some of that insight with you. My ex is going to be in my life forever, so I may as well enjoy getting along with him. I have some gratuitous unicorns. Where are they? There they are. If you know me, you'll appreciate this. Anyway, I wanted to talk about, it's really easy to assume negative motivation when you're dealing with your exes, but if you step back and look at all your situations objectively, typically they're not really trying to thwart everything that you do. It's just a struggle from both sides. It doesn't really matter who initiated it or how it played out, but it's a big deal, and each person is going to deal with the situation in their own way. So you really want to keep the same respect for each other that you always had. Even when you were married, you chose to marry that person for some reason, so you must think they're okay. You know, maybe you're the person that ended up having to move into a new home, and you think, ah, it's super sucky, I got the raw end of the deal, but then that person's probably still living in the home that you shared as a family. They have to rebuild from there, and I don't think that's any easier. So learning to forgive is a really big deal. You have to forgive your spouse for everything that got you to that point, everything that may have happened along the way, but also forgive yourself, which was a really hard one for me to do. People say really horrible things and do terrible things when they're hurt, but you have to let it go. This was a big one for me. I had to learn to stop feeling sorry for myself. I have to admit that the first major holiday that I spent alone after my divorce was Thanksgiving. Pretty much just spent it having a huge pity party. It was pretty awesome. And then I realized that was pathetic, and all I was doing was focusing on everything that I'd lost and what was sad instead of looking at it toward great potential for a new future with a whole lot of insight about myself to make it even better. This next one is coming slowly. I think that this is a cliche saying, but you really do, you're able to choose happiness. You can choose to look at the situation from a positive point of view. You can choose to be happy for your ex, and whatever decisions that my ex-husband chooses to make for himself, I'm happy for him because I want him to be happy for the sake of our daughter. I love this one. I had to really kind of train everybody in my life to stop trying to talk negatively about him. It really doesn't do you any good to vilify your ex, and for some reason people believe that a good way to show support for you is to talk about how bad your ex is. But I truly think if you can paint a loving picture and convince your family and friends that this is actually a positive relationship, so we're not married anymore, but we still have a good relationship, that actually becomes reality after a while if you keep on practicing it. So everybody who's been divorced with kids obviously has the goal of minimizing the impact on their children throughout the process. For us, it became very apparent early on that we have extremely different parenting styles, but once we learned to just not sweat the small stuff and let it go, it was a whole lot easier. We still have to be a team when it comes to the big decisions that involve our daughter. I am very guilty of sometimes telling her, we're not going to do that because that's daddy's rule, and I realize what I need to be doing is saying, daddy and I talked about this, and this is how it's going to be. So I do make an effort to thank him whenever I can. I really actually have a fabulous ex-husband, so perhaps this is all easier for me than it is for most people, but he's reliable, he does his part, he's a fabulous dad, so I want him to know that I recognize that and I acknowledge it. I have a tip that actually came from a friend. This isn't one that's been an issue much for me, but we really have to stay out of each other's personal lives, and if you don't need to know, you really don't need to know, right? If it doesn't affect your kids, then you don't really need to share that information with each other. But the bottom line is, I still view my ex-husband as a friend and an ally, and I realized this recently when I was filling out some emergency information forms, and I just wrote his name in there, and I thought, you know what, if I really needed something, he still would come and be at my rescue, and I would definitely do the same for him. So while we have both embarked on a new life that's separate from each other, I think that that's happier for both of us, and that we still are committed to a common goal of raising a beautiful little girl, so we can do that now separately from new households and be happy about it. So it was a tough journey, and I think I hit the lowest point in my life, but I'm in a much happier place than I've ever been in my life now, and incidentally, I do want to point out, I presented here about a year ago on why I have only one kid, and I wanted everybody to stop nagging me. They don't nag me anymore, so that's wonderful.